Join us as we follow one-off builds to all-out restorations in Stuart, Florida's Dreamboat District, home to some of the best custom boat builders in the world. From modest to over-the-top, industry experts from the district's premier facilities show how it's done. Fiberglass repair, custom paintwork, engine rigging, electronics installations, and more. And boating editor George Labonte shares the stories of boaters who have already turned their dreams into reality. This is Florida Sportsman Project Dreamboat.
The project we're going to start with today is the LNH 33. It's an older 1995, built back in the beginning, early days of the company, hull number 5, and one of the only boats that we let go out of the shop partially complete. The owner did some fiberglass fabrication of his own. The boat really came out very nice. Jump ahead 20-something years, the boat goes on the market. A gentleman from Ocean City, Maryland, Jake Robinson, ends up buying it, calls us up, asks us if we're interested in doing a redo on the boat, bringing it back in and seeing what needs to be done on it. And it certainly did show its age, so we joined up with Jake and brought the project into the shop to begin it. So we removed everything. The paintwork in the engine room needed to be redone. The paintwork in the cabin needed to be redone. The paintwork on the outside of the boat obviously needed to be redone. One of the jobs I do, aside from doing fiberglass fabrication, is paintwork as well. And when we got to the end of that boat, most of the paintwork had been done, but the finishing touches and the non-skid, which is the last part of the paint process on the boat, hadn't been finished yet. So we stepped in, LNH stepped in and finished that project up so that we could keep the ball moving and start getting into the rigging and wiring stage on the boat. Jake wanted to put some teak on the boat, and he has seen some of our later boats where we're doing the faux teak finish on a lot of the control pods, teak transoms. Everything that you see done in a high gloss teak finish can now be done in what's described and called faux teak finish. We got hooked up with Monique. She works out of Merritt. Comes very highly recommended. Before Monique arrives on site, we paint a base coat down on the part that, to be faux teaked. It's a custom color that she has mixed up that is the base coat for this faux teak operation. She's an artist, and it's really something to see it done.
I'm Monique Richter, and I work for a bunch of different boat builders, and I basically mimic teak wood, but with all grip paints. So I produce a product that lasts for about 10 years. You don't have to do any kind of maintenance, and it looks just like teak. I started doing artwork when I was about 3 years old, so I've always done fine art. And I recently have been seeing boats that have painted transoms, and I just felt there's a need to fine-tune them, make them a little different so they looked like realistic teak. And I do all the painted names, too. So all the gold leaf I do by hand, and platinum leaf I do by hand, and it's an old trade that's it's a dying trade that I learned from old timers, that master gold leafers who taught me the trade. I have multiple assistants that work for me. I'm the only artist that works for the company. They assist me with all the equipment, get the whole job sites ready, and they're amazing. With the paint, you could really make it exactly how you want it. You don't have to worry about a bad piece of grain or two different colors of teak boards coming together. Everything is the same tone, and it lasts, it's durable. You know, you don't have pieces of boards that are getting warped or buckling. It's all grip paint, so I mean, it lasts for 10 years. You know, it's just like a regular white paint job, but it's just brown colors. Every piece I do is for the builder. LNH, they got a nice flare to them in the bow, and I'm gonna have a nice like flare to their helm pod with a grain, you know, and just kind of make it their own. So they look different than another boat builder I'm doing. And then it's more artwork. You know, everyone has their own piece. Like I sign a little M in all of my teak grains. So it's kind of like a one of a kind. And it's more art than just a faux paint. To do faux teak versus to just maintain the wood every 3 years is the same cost. And you don't have to do more maintenance. You just leave it alone and you just enjoy your boat. You don't gotta worry about the bright work.
We come back in with the clear coat. So the first coat's done, no touch. We just spray on top of her work and spray a light coat of clear on it. Put on 8-10 coats of clear coat on top of that and preserve her perfect piece of artwork.